Hi guys, welcome to Go Thug Yourself here on the Big Vito Brand. I'm one of your hosts, Noelle Harla Lagrasso. I am here with my husband and partner, as always, Big Vito Lagrasso. We are joined in a Philadelphia studio by our dear friends, the Bogies, Danny J and Sal Filimine. How are you guys today?
Good. How are you guys?
How are you doing?
And we're alive.
Danima died a little bit ago.
Dan has the high blood sugar. I have the bad back. Vito can't stop flexing. Neen, you're the only one all right.
No, I'm not all right.
Neen is burning cutlets.
Neen is the burning the cutlets?
Burn the cutlets.
I don't burn cutlets.
Gelato cutlets. Gelato.
That's a shame, Vito. When you talk about Neen's cousins that way, it's just a shame. You know that. It's just not right.
We're not talking about Tina. Remember Big Tina?
Yeah,
that's the cousin.
Yes.
So that's going to lead me into today's game. We'll be playing. We're going to play an old-fashioned game of what would you rather or who would you rather? And there's going to be some pretty serious choices. I know Vito already has one in mind that I'm not going to comment on specifically for Dan. So ooh. I'm not going to say.
I hate you.
Charity hates you. So I have my chunky little list here on my Coco Little Mermaid phone, and we're going to follow along, play as we usually do. We'll go around the group, and everybody will give their answer.
Don't you want to tell everybody the big news about what we accomplished this week? Go ahead. Tell everybody.
I was saving that because you did make an announcement, and Virtue said something, but we are now coming to you on Alexa, all Amazon devices, Fire devices, Alexa. We're available in your flash briefings. So if you go to your Alexa app, go flash briefings, type in the Big Vito Brand. We have developed a lovely app for you guys, and you can hear us every time you say, Alexa, flash briefings. Alexa, don't say them. Stop.
But, you know, it's a pretty big thing for us. We want to thank everybody who contributed to the brand. You know, without you guys, the fans, the people who work for us, everybody involved, this wouldn't have been able to be possible. We want to thank everybody for their support. And let's get the show on the road and let the games begin.
Let the games begin. Okay. Let's see. First question. Now, some of these questions are just questions that curiosity. Some of them are, you know, who would you rather? Some, you know, things like this. So my first question is one that I debated myself, as I love food. We all love food except Vito. We all love food. So this question is for everyone. Would you rather have everything you eat to be too salty or everything you eat not salty enough no matter how much salt you add?
What?
So would you rather your food be too salty for the rest of your life or not salty enough for the rest of your life?
Dan, you being, you know, entrepreneur of the Chinese delicacies, why don't you go first?
Okay. You can settle when it's not salty enough and just be like, I wish I had a little bit more salt. But the face you make when it's too salty is always like, like this. So I would go with unsalty enough for the rest of my life.
Neen, how about you?
I would tend to agree with my husband. You can replace salt with other things. So, and if it's too salty, it's not cool.
Right, you can spice it with other stuff. Vito, even though this is not your forte, although you are a chef, so it might be.
I would take not salty enough because you can always add other ingredients to give it other flavors. You know, not unlike Christine's cutlets where they're always over-salted and burnt.
See, now he stole my answer and reworded it, and then he offended me.
I know, he took a shot. Now, that's not right. Why is he taking a shot at your cutlets?
That's because we're breaking into Alexa. We're starting off with a bang.
You banged Alexa?
Yeah, probably.
Probably.
He probably did. He's banged everyone out.
I can't comment on that right now.
If I ask it, what do you think it'll say?
I'm telling you, it'll say something like that, or I don't understand the question.
I don't understand the question.
Let me ask it. Alexa. Has Vito ever banged you? It wouldn't answer. It shut off. Look.
It shut off.
Alexa's in the black book.
Oh, yeah, must be. Yeah. Color black, so apparently it is. All right, the next question would be, would you rather be unable to use any search engines, including Google, or be completely unable to use social media for the rest of your life?
I'd give up Google.
Yeah, me too. I'm giving up Google.
How about you?
I would give up social media.
You would?
Less drama.
Yeah, you know what? I have to Google stuff. Like, I have to. I can't not Google
stuff. I'll ask somebody. I'm always talking. I'm friends with a lot of people. But, like, my social media I use not just to keep in touch with people, but I use it for my own professionalism. I use it for DJing. I use it for my podcast and stuff like that. So I'll get out there and I'll tell everybody if they'll listen.
You know what? Now that I think about it, I probably would give up social media because I'm like you. I need to Google everything. No, that's not true. How many times do we sit here and we watch a movie or
how
something?
How many times are we driving at 95 and she's on Facebook while we're driving? And she's stop. Driving.
Yeah, but still, but listen.
Like this.
Stop, but listen.
And I'm like this.
Yeah, but how many times do I say, oh, I wonder if that's a real town? Ooh, when was so-and-so born? Ooh, and I'm constantly Googling stuff.
Mm-hmm. Hey, I'll give you a prime example of how this works. We just went through this. You just put something up on my Facebook that said that it was a meme that said Goofy from Disney is a cow.
Yes.
And it was inaccurate because Goofy is not a cow. Everybody is thinking of Horace, who is the cow that dated Clarabelle and Goofy dated Clarabelle. I know everything about Disney. But all these other people were like, oh, really? She's a cow? Goofy's a cow? You see, if you Googled, you could probably see everybody was like, oh, it's a big debate, but Goofy's a dog. If you asked a friend, they would have been like, oh, yeah, Goofy's a cow, because people just do that.
Because people just do that.
You got to find out.
Goofy is the dog that sold out. That's why Pluto is angry.
Yeah, I believe so. I mean, he wears pants and drives a car. If I was Pluto, I'd be pissed.
He became the man. Yes.
Yeah, they don't let Pluto drive a car.
Goofy is the Disney equivalent of transgender.
Listen, they need to get rid of Goofy and Pluto and hire Gunner and Bruiser.
I think so. Bruiser's horrible, so is Gunner. They should be dogs. Bruiser's kind of already a Disney dog. Here's a good one for Vito, because you guys know, and I know, but the internet does not know, that Vito bathes, like, what would you say, 3 times a day or more? 2 or 3 times a day, Vito takes a shower. In between that time, he washes his face. He shaves more than once a day. He's very meticulous, but he's also highly addicted to the internet. So here's the question. Would you rather give up bathing for a month or the internet for a month?
The internet.
I knew. I kind of knew it.
Oh, that was a no-brainer.
What would you guys do?
Wow. The internet for a month, meaning I can go back to it.
Yes.
Or bathing for a month. I would have to give up the internet for a month because I'm not a crumb.
Yeah, me too. I'm not a crumb bum.
I'm not a
crumb bum.
This is difficult for me.
Or I could be locked in a dark house with just the internet and look like a Sasquatch.
I mean, if I didn't have to go out in public for a month, then okay, maybe I would give up the shower.
I don't have to go out in public. I stay at home all the time. I mean, you'd have to deal with like my sink, but I could still use like perfume and dry shampoo on my hair. But if I didn't have Netflix, what the hell am I going to do?
Dad, as a bonus, because you picked to give up the internet, you could shower with all your female friends, compliments of the Big Vito brand.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Black book.
Blackbook.com.
Blackbook.com.
Wait, let's Google that. Is that actually a website?
Google it. I want to see if it's a website.
Oh, Neil, you have your Geek Squad hat on tonight. Nice.
The Geek Squad was parked in front of
our
house.
Yeah, no, parked in front. Don't you hear me? I swear.
I love it. Neil, are you Googling it for real?
I sure as shit am. Yeah. And it blackbook.com.
There's a black book. Somebody stole your shit.
I just hope my name.
Wow. What is it?
I've seen your name on interesting websites, but if it comes up on blackbook.com.
Buy now. What is this?
Shut up a minute, Dan. Marie, everything from VIN decoding to equity data mining and portfolio analysis to residual forecast.
I think this is the dark web.
Black Book is the resource you need.
You need to get out of that dark web shit before somebody shows up.
You can do all the things.
All the things are on there.
All the things.
All the things. I'd pass on all the things because you never know. You might get some Ted Bundy shit going on.
Oh, let's go to the next question.
Okay, the next question. Would you rather be married to a 10 with a bad personality or a 6 with an amazing personality?
6.
Yeah, 6.
6.
I'm going to say 6, too.
He's going to say 10 because he's...
But see, you bang the 10 once, but then that horrible personality gets in, and then you never want to bang it again unless it's a baseball bat.
Ooh.
Difficult for you because I'm a 10 with a good personality.
Yes, honey. I date a fucking 3.
You need a 3.
If you could be in a pursuit channel because you're fishing.
Cook, clean, do all the.
Nobody said cooking and cleaning. They said personality.
Shit, you know what I mean?
I mean, I got a 10 with a good personality. He's got a smart mouth, but you know.
Mine's a dumb mouth.
Mine's too.
Hold on a second. Hey. I haven't had any 10s with
good person. Here's the deal. People always fear intelligence.
Oh, here we go.
So that's what
I fear you because you're intelligent.
She, when I open my mouth, she wants to do bodily harm to me because I might expose her as less intelligent than I.
Get she's a fool. Out of here.
That's what it is. It's that alien shit. You know.
You know, when she got that diploma from Villanova, it's, you know, they say Villanova, it's Villanova because that's where she really got it from. And she added the extra letters. Look at me, guys. I got a diploma from Villanova. No, it's Villanova. Because we know sometimes you act a little stupid.
It's a different colored crayon.
Listen, I'll admit that I don't have a whole lot of common sense, but most people who are very intelligent don't. So whatever.
Listen, he just sat over here and said women that have that are a 10 don't have a good personality. He said he never met one while he's sitting next to his wife.
That means you have a great personality. Take it as a compliment and the glass is half full.
You know why? You know why, babe? Because you're a 10 plus, honey.
Oh, look at how he's backpedaled.
10 plus.
You don't want me to knock him on the floor like last week. You see that? You're 10 plus, honey. Don't hit me. No, no violence.
I just washed my face with you. You know, good stuff.
How many showers was that for you today? 8?
No, babe. All right, next question, honey.
Would you rather kill one innocent person? We're 5 people who committed minor crimes.
Where are you from?
What? Wait a minute, wait. When I kill one innocent person.
One innocent person or 5 people that committed minor crimes, like nicking something from the dollar store or something.
Oh, 5.
You kill 5 people?
Yes.
Kill one.
Well, that's called a gateway crime.
A gateway crime.
So that pulling shit from a 5 and dime would eventually lead to pulling a armed robbery, which would then lead to a poor person at a gas station trying to get to college getting shot over $55 in the register, and then that person now committed a murder. So now I'm doing community injustice.
Oh my God, this guy.
Man is like in some kind of butterfly effect fucking.
Fuck right it is. I am straight.
What would you do, babe? Would you kill one innocent or 5 minor criminals?
Do you guys remember the movie with Charles Bronson when he was a vigilante? I can't think of the name.
What's the name? Yeah, I know.
You know what it is.
I do, and they just did the remake with Bruce Willis.
Oh, God. Google.
Okay. Google.
So, being that I watched that movie, being a crusader, I would kill 5 people.
I would do it with a mask on.
Oh.
And not a mask like a snow mask, like I'm a murderer, like a domino mask, like I'm a vigilante.
Yeah, I think so. Christine wouldn't need a mask. She wears
and death wish.
Death wish. There you go. Death. I would have a giant V on my shirt, and they would say, "Why are you killing me? Who are you?" And I'd be like, "Oh, I'm Vito LaGrasso. It's L-O-G-R." I have cards. You know.
Sorry, guys. I gotta blow my nose.
I'm Vito LaGrasso.
I'll probably wind up with my Wikipedia. Dan Boji.
Yeah, they say he's a lot shorter in person. I don't understand that.
What happened? He's so small. I don't know. Here's a good one. Would you rather be reincarnated as a fly or cease to exist after you die?
Cease to exist.
Oh, yes. Yeah, cease to exist.
A fly only lives 24 hours to 7 days.
Yeah, I don't want to be a fly.
No, I mean, I don't eat shit all day.
Yeah, no.
What about you?
No, I'm just, I can't bathe.
Flies don't bathe, so you just want to die?
Hey, you're like, oh, shit all day.
Well, they eat poop.
Yeah, Vito doesn't even like to eat.
My daughter looks at me.
Even more work. Disgusting, they get the poop, they dissolve it, and then they suck up their throw-up.
Ew.
So they're fucking the throw-up of poop.
What about the people who swat flies with those swatters and everything? You're not looking, you're getting crushed. I want to see
what if coming. Those flies are reincarnated five people who committed small crimes?
Oh my God.
Yeah, I mean, you can really tie this into a whole large way
to get like,
or if you guys really want to get creative here, I would come back as a fly and then haunt Christine's cutlets and be that fly that won't go away.
Oh my God.
I would come back as Bumble Fly.
All right. Would you rather have one real get out of jail free card? Like you could kill those five people and you're not going to jail. Or have a key that opens any door in the world.
The key. I don't do anything bad. Or I get away with it, at least.
Neen?
Get out of jail free.
Because she can't get away with shit.
No, she's going to kill somebody anyway.
I've got a list.
And she would kill somebody and then she would fall.
Yeah, she would fall over
and crying, and then fall and she'd be like, ah, motherfuck, and then broke her ankle or something, and then they would catch her that quick.
And then as they're coming to catch her, they say, you know, guys, I used to be a ballet dancer. You could look at my
and they'd be like, and then they would turn to me and say, thank you, Mr. LaGrasso, for calling this in. I'd be like, not a problem.
Big V and little V.
Yeah.
No. Don't you have a question, an important question that you wanted to ask Dan?
Yes. Well, first I'll give my answer. I will take the key to the universe.
Okay.
Into the universe.
To the universe.
Dan, I have a question for you.
Yes.
Now, this is a good question, something we've talked about. Would you rather, okay, have an intimate affair with your mother-in-law like you want to, or would you have a one-time, one-night special with one of Christine's sisters?
What? Oh, my God. No, you cannot answer that question.
I can totally answer this. I already have it done.
No! Oh, my God.
Because I can't travel back in time and get Ange when she was in her prime, and I have to deal with, I hate everybody. I hate men. I hate women. I hate air. I hate oxygen. I couldn't deal with that. So I'd have to do one of the sisters. And because Melissa's the baby, I could not do Melissa, which means I'd have to do Ange. But because Ange is annoying, it would have to be angry sex.
Okay.
You better hope your brother-in-law never hears this. He'll try and shoot you.
Well, he probably agrees with me. Yeah, I'd have angry sex too.
I mean, I have another sister.
And wouldn't you want to do a one-time dog cage?
She looks like me, though.
Yeah, but she's
part of the dog cage. They got rid of the dog cage. He can't do a dog cage anymore.
And if you had a chance to hit that ass, boy, I'm telling you.
On the dog cage? The only thing is, the dog cage now is about so big. So I'd be hitting my back.
You'd be getting low on that dog cage, getting super low.
This is terrible. I can't believe you answered that.
Why?
You should be ashamed of yourself.
Why? That was a logical answer.
If you didn't get caught having this relationship with your mother-in-law, it can go on. I mean, if it started
Let me explain something to you. Either way, it's a dark tunnel. Either way.
I mean, technically, it's a dark tunnel.
All right, so all you guys out there thinking about having relations with your mother-in-law, think twice.
Because I could romance my mother-in-law and she'd be like, and like, she'd be happy for like 3 or 4 seconds or so. But the other one's never happy.
Look at our faces. We're like,
That is not true.
She's happy when she sees herself.
Well, she is happy when she looks at herself. But she's also very happy when the boy does well.
One time, the light of her life, her son. One time she was here, and I forget what the question was, but she said, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm a size 6. I said, Ann, just because you're in a size 6 doesn't mean you are a size 6.
Oh, damn.
Wow. I'm a guy, and I don't feed into bullshit. But I couldn't. No, that would be angry sex.
That was wrong.
That was stiff, Dan.
This is very unnecessary. Let's move on. Moving on.
A good question. There we go.
All right. Here's another excellent question for everyone. Would you rather have one nipple or 2 belly buttons?
Ooh. I would have 2 belly buttons because then you can get your finger like this. And you'd be like, because if you had one nipple, it would look odd.
That's true. You look like Cyclops.
If you had 2 belly buttons, you'd be symmetrical.
That's bad. One nipple or 2 belly buttons?
This could be strange. I'll have to go with one nipple.
Really?
Why?
Is it one nipple on one boob, or do you still have 2 boobs and only one nipple?
It doesn't give specifics. I'm going to assume it's like a Cyclops boob situation.
Then no, we have to go with the belly button.
What about the
belly button?
Because then you can dress it up. You can get 2 belly button rings.
That's what I was going to say. If I can pierce more things, I'm totally going with 2. Plus, like, I like my nipples too much, so does Vito. So I couldn't take one of them away.
And if you want to get really dirty with it, you could paint it up like their eyes. And I'll just leave it there.
I'd probably tattoo around them and make them interesting. So it's me.
What was he doing?
He's tattooing around his belly buttons again.
Or you make the 2 belly buttons look like 2 wheels and it could be like a profile of a car.
Oh my God, he's so stupid.
Tattooed on the belly.
Wait, I'm trying to discover a good question because some of these are really stupid.
Well, Gunner has had enough.
I'd rather live in a giant desert or a giant dessert. Like, that's stupid.
That doesn't make sense.
Makes no sense at all. None. I'm trying to find, like, a good one. So, would you rather be covered in fur or covered in scales?
Oh, fur, because that would be cuddly.
Yeah, I want to go with fur, too. Mean.
Scales.
I figured.
Because I don't want people petting me all the time.
Or cuddling her or anything like that.
Uh-uh.
I know yours, it's gotta be scales because you hate hair.
No, she would have to be in a sun lamp.
Vito would rather be dead.
I mean, I don't mind getting held and hugged and kissed and all that. But you know, if you're furry, everybody's gonna want to touch you all the time. And I just know.
Well, Christine, you're furry now. I mean, everybody touches you anyway.
You know what?
Are you guys?
Dan's agree. Oh,
yeah. I'm going to do a disgusting one. Disgusting one. Would you rather eat an egg with a half-formed chicken inside or eat 5 cooked cockroaches?
The egg. The roaches would just skeeze me out. But the egg, I possibly could fry that egg, which means I'd have breakfast and fried chicken at the same time.
Good point, Dan. Oh. I'm going to go with the egg.
That could be like a new KFC breakfast sandwich.
It probably already is a KFC breakfast sandwich. They're on the cusp. It's either that or Chick-fil-A is serving it on a biscuit.
Oh, that's the best in the world.
I don't know. When I was in college, they made me
eat cockroaches?
They made me in biology crack open an egg with an embryo in it. And I cracked the egg and I scrambled the yolk and killed the embryo. So, shut up. And I'm scarred from that. So I don't know if I could do the egg thing.
Could you eat the cockroaches?
I could probably eat the cockroaches.
What about you?
I'd eat the roaches with some Tabasco sauce and add everything onto it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Fry them up. Whatever. Hold your nose. Put him in an air fryer.
That's like some deep engine shit.
Get yourself together, girl.
I am together. I'm eating the egg because I'm getting fried chicken. Dan and I are going to have a good time with that. All right? Dan's chicken joint. You got a chicken joint now, Dan? Would you guys rather have out of control body hair or out of control body odor?
Hair. Gotta go in hair, man, because if you smell good, they'll say, come here, Sasquatch, you sexy thing.
What about you? You hate hair and you hate body odor. You kill yourself again?
Right.
You'd rather be dead. Me too. I can't stand either. I'd rather be done. There's nothing I can think of that, Would you rather never be able to wear pants or never be able to wear shorts? That's
never be able to wear pants or never be able to wear shorts.
Never be able to wear shorts. Because I have fat thighs now, so.
I would probably go with pants so I can have shorts, because in the summer, there's nothing worse than wearing pants in the summer.
I think we would have to go with never being able to wear pants, probably, because it's freaking hot here.
You know what? Even in the winter up here, now imagine it gets down to like 12 degrees up here, you know?
But oh, yeah, which tonight, yeah.
Like, but like if I sat there and was going to UPS and I had like a t-shirt, a sweatshirt, and then my insulated hoodie and then a pair of shorts, just my knees would be cold.
Well, it would be caliente for Big Vito, boy. It would be caliente all the way.
Everybody, what caliente is.
It's a naked resort. Naked and naked black book naked.
Neat. Would you rather have to live at Caliente for the rest of your life or be stuck living with Vito for the rest of your life? Choices.
Oh, God. I'll go Caliente, man.
I knew that was going
to
happen.
I'd go Caliente, man.
I would kill you. I would murder you in your sleep.
Vito, what would you rather live Vito, would you rather live in Antarctica for the rest of your life or live with me?
He's going to live with me. There's no way he can.
All those northern places, there's a lot of vampires.
Yeah, I mean.
Well, I mean, you know, well, Antarctica and Nino both cold, and I would get a halfway decent cutlet if I live with Nino. So, like, I guess I'd bite the bullet and move in with Dan.
That
wasn't the question.
And I were watching you from closed circuit television, laughing our asses off.
Listen, we all know how much he hates the cold. He hates the cold more than possibly anything in the world. He would live with me. He knows it.
And suffer.
But if you're up there in Antarctica, you get with some kind of Eskimo dude, and he'll make you like salmon cutlets.
They have lots of salmon there. Think about it.
God.
You could wear cool fur coats, like a Ric Flair coat.
No.
Nah, he ain't doing it. Come on.
I'll suffer with Nene and put up with her stupid dances, murmur struts, the stretching routines, breaking the dance bar, the 19 couches, friggin' dishes left in the sink, never doing
it. Come on, man, I'm going to stretch. Hey! Look, you scared the dog. You upset the dog. Bite him, Gunner. He's being mean to me.
All right, guys. This is going to be one that's difficult for me because I'm going to explain to you after I say the question why. Would you rather every shirt you wear to be kind of itchy or only be able to use one ply toilet paper for the rest of your life? Let me explain. If I go to your house and you do not have the appropriate toilet paper, I judge you. It's the only time I judge anybody on anything. So if I go to your house and you have like terrible toilet paper, I'm definitely judging you. If like I go to your house and you have Cottonelle, we're down. So for me, I have to take the itchy sweater because I don't play when it comes to toilet paper. I'm very serious about my toilet paper. I don't know about you guys, but that's like a big thing
for me. You can double up single ply toilet paper.
Yep.
No, it's rough shit.
No,
it's see-through.
Listen, there is no way I could be itchy all the fucking time.
I would get the oven mitt. And I would just use the
oven mitt.
And just wash it in the tub.
I'll itch every day like poison oak, but I cannot use one ply.
Double up the one ply. Nothing says I can't double up the one ply.
I go to the Inventors Network and invent Danny J's ass mitt.
Ew.
And be like, and you wipe it, and then you just wash it off.
Neen, when I worked where you guys work, I actually brought toilet paper from home with me for work.
Ha, because you didn't like that toilet paper.
I didn't like the toilet paper. I'm very picky about toilet paper. Am I right? Like, I get mad.
Yes, honey.
How about you? Would you rather be itchy or use one ply toilet paper?
One ply, son. One ply.
Nah, I can't do it.
It would be expensive, but I'd do it.
All right.
Final question, guys.
Okay. All right. Give me a minute. I want to get like a really, really good question.
Dad, you really wouldn't do the mother-in-law and keep having an affair.
Oh, my God. Stop.
You know what, though? It's like, you know when you see Ric Flair now and you feel bad?
Stop it.
There was a champ there one day, but it's not today.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, but Dan, you just think about it. You got an excuse to get out of the house. You got an excuse to go hang out with your mother-in-law. You know you got to get fed. You're going to have sex.
Oh, my God. I can't.
I'm asking the last question.
Think about it.
This is what you just said. Would you rather know an uncomfortable truth or believe a comfortable lie?
I'd rather know the truth because I like to know what I'm dealing with.
Neen?
Lie to her face. She loves it.
What?
Lie to me, baby. Lie to me.
Lie to me.
That's a rough one. I don't know.
All right.
Rather than you, I would say lie to you because you let things bother you too much.
Yeah.
I compartmentalize and I use it for later.
Yeah.
She doesn't. She'll stay up for days.
Yeah, the uncomfortable lie or no. Don't tell me don't tell me the bad news or
I just lied to you.
Lie to me, baby. Woo!
Lie to me. What about you, baby?
You know, Neen, you know, this week on TV, you really look very slim. I'm very impressed with what you're doing with your diet. You look so.
Is he being honest with me or is he breaking
up?
You're giving up. That is what he's doing. Thanks.
Take common sense.
Didn't even realize.
Apologize to Neen. That was so.
I didn't say anything wrong. She is. Friggin' losing weight because it looks like she slimmed down this week.
It does actually look like she's.
That's why I said it. So what the hell is everybody?
Because we're talking about lies and truth, and you look.
The camera's further away. That's probably why.
He's such a dork.
I can't. You know, Dan.
What is your answer to the question?
Answer the question.
Help me.
What?
I was Dan. I wouldn't help you. You're insulting people's wives.
I friggin' set Dan up with his mother-in-law. For Christ's sake.
Will you answer the question? Will you want the lie or do you want the truth?
I want somebody to lie to me and I believe the lie, although I want to live with the uncomfortable truth.
Correct.
I'll probably live with the uncomfortable truth because I could deal with it. Because if I catch you lying to me and I find out, if I think that's worse. So I would rather you just tell me the truth and we'll deal with it.
Your one ear is bigger than the other.
That's good. You know why?
Why?
Because it's the year I don't need shit.
You got cauliflower ear. I was just being silly.
All right.
Let's wrap this show up with everybody's fantastic plugs. And we have this new audience that's with us from Alexa and a bunch of other different podcast distribution places. So, guys, say it loud, say it clear.
Why don't
we
let Neen lead off the plugs? Because she probably has some good things to talk about.
Right.
Since we're doing Alexa, Neen, lead us off. Go ahead.
You guys know I'm the most boring one of the group, but SouthPhillyNeen.com, SouthPhillyNeen on Facebook, at SouthPhillyNeen on Twitter, at SouthPhillyNeen on Instagram, and
what do we get?
We're on the Big Vito gram,
and what do we
and
get?
That's it.
And what do we get on these famous things?
Not much. I mean, you know, you can talk to me if you want. Inbox me with questions. Inbox here.
Updated SouthPhillyNeen.com. I just updated it.
There you go. Ask me your Foley questions. I don't know. Something.
Anything.
Can I get Big Angie's phone number?
Listen, I'm busy with my kids. I don't have time to do what you guys do.
We'll make personal appearances at bar mitzvahs.
There you go. Bar and bat mitzvahs. Yeah. Yeah, they love her.
Me and Aunt Mary Pat.
There you go. Damn, what are your clubs this week?
But, all right, so now down to real plugs. DJBProductions.com. You can get me there for all DJing needs, large and small. Go to ThatWayCoolWrestlingShow.com. On DJBProductions.com, you can see all the links to the podcast. We have multiple podcasts, including That Way Cool Wrestling Show, DJs After Dark, Cave's Not Included, and soon to be coming, Have You Seen It Lately? You can also go on all the Facebooks, which are That Way Cool Wrestling Show, DJs After Dark, Cave's Not Included, which goes along with Lost and Saturday Mornings, and also Have You Seen It Lately? They're all on there. You can also look up DJ Danny J, and also go on Twitter, which is TWCWS Podcast. You can check us out on there as well. And then, of course, we're right here on Go Thug Yourself, right here on the Big Vito brand.
Vito, would you like to do some plugs? I love Go Thug Yourself.
Thug Yourself.
I just want to say that I am very happy and pleased with the brand, and I want to thank everybody again for listening and tuning in. And I will let the voice of reason do all the plugs.
He just exposed me as your voice of reason.
Exposed. Ah, we got to bring everything, not you. You don't need to get on every train.
I get on everything because you want to be popular.
A one-time show that was like the most popular thing we ever did. Yes. It was like nothing. So here are the plugs, guys. Thank you, everybody that joins us on Alexa. We're available if you look under Flash Briefings in your Alexa app. You can program the Big Vito Band. We're also on TuneIn Podcast on your Alexa app, so you can listen to the podcast one at a time. You can schedule us the Flash Briefing. Go to thebigvitobrand.com. We post our videos on there, different events and things that we're doing. Also, we are on our distributor, anchor.fm/thebigvitobrand. If you go on that page, click the purple button. That helps us out. You'll be able to do a little supporting of the Big Vito brand. Check out Flipbook, who's our sponsor on there. They help us out. We set a record in 1 week of podcasting. We've been back one solid week, and we set a whole month-long record. We're almost to triple our numbers. So we want to thank everybody.
You're welcome.
Joining us and tripling our numbers. We got more shows coming. We're adding more shows. We're returning more shows. So keep staying with us. Get at us on Twitter at the Big Vito Brand, at Reality Capital T Spiller. We are the same on Instagram. Also on Facebook, we are at the Big Vito Brand. We do a lot of live shows on there. We have a Patreon that's at the Big Vito Brand. We're going to do some live videos on there. Vito's going to do some talking to everybody on there. So become a patron. You can click the little button. There's different tiers that you can subscribe to. And I believe that's it. So guys, join us tomorrow where we will have another fantastic episode of Spilling the Reality with Devin Sturgis. Myself and Foxy will be back. No Nick G tomorrow, unless he feels like chiming in. So, because he was hysterical the other night. So, if you guys want to join us for that, we would greatly appreciate it. We hope to see you soon. And I'm going to say goodnight. Bye-bye.
Bye. Cheers.
This has been a production of The Big Vito Brand. Make sure to check us out at thebigvitobrand.com.